morning, all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. This chapter is coming in your half yearly test. That is why I had to. पहले हम लोगों ने डिसाइड किया था फुटप्रिंट्स विदाउट फीट, बट देन दिस चैप्टर आल्सो वाज एडेड इन द हाफ अर्ली सिलेबस. सो यू हैव टू डू दिस चैप्टर आल्सो, द मेकिंग ऑफ अ साइंटिस्ट. टुडे आई विल सेंड यू द पोर्शन. ओके, और तो जो बताए थे वही है, बस ये चैप्टर एक्स्ट्रा ऐड हुआ है.
मैम, प्रैक्टिकल टेस्ट का कब होगा?
कौन सा टेस्ट?
प्रैक्टिकल टेस्ट मैम, जो आप बोली थी कि मॉक टेस्ट जैसा होगा.
देखो, हो भी सकता नहीं भी हो सकता. तुम लोग तो अब ये मुझे नहीं पता, हो भी सकता नहीं भी हो सकता. प्रोसेस तुम लोग को बता दिया जाएगा कैसे देना है टेस्ट. स्नैप होमवर्क पे होगा ये, क्लास ग्रुप में नहीं होगा. क्लास ग्रुप में नई कॉपी भेजनी होगी. इट विल बी हेल्ड थ्रू द स्नैप होमवर्क एंड यू हैव टू बी केयरफुल अबाउट द टाइमिंग बिकॉज टाइमर विल बी सेट इन दैट एंड आफ्टर द एग्जाम इज ओवर सम टाइम विल बी गिवन फॉर यू टू अपलोड योर कॉपीज. So you have to.
मैम, तीन घंटे का
है. देखो अब क्या होता है, पता चल जाएगा ना. यू विल गेट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन बिफोर हैंड. यू विल गेट ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन. ओके, सो दिस चैप्टर इज ऑल्सो देयर इन योर हाफ ईयरली. टू चैप्टर्स हैज बीन डिलीटेड, क्वेश्चन ऑफ ट्रस्ट एंड मिडनाइट विजिटर. डिलीटेड चैप्टर्स लिस्ट आई सेंड टुडे आल्सो. हैव ऑल ऑफ यू सीन इट? हेलो.
यस मैम.
ओके, यू जस्ट पुट अ क्रॉस इन योर बुक सो दैट यू रिमेम्बर इट. यू कैन पुट अ क्रॉस इन द बुक वेयर द चैप्टर्स नेम आर गिवन. सो मिडनाइट विजिटर एंड क्वेश्चन ऑफ ट्रस्ट इज डिलीटेड. And this chapter is coming. So four chapters from this footprints without feet. So this chapter, as the title suggests, it is about a scientist, the making of a scientist, how he became a scientist. Read and find out how did a book become a turning point in Richard Ebright's life. And what is the name of the scientist? The name of the scientist is Richard Ebright. So Richard Ebright has received the Scholar Award and the Scaring Plough Award for Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. So he's a very famous scientist. And he has received many awards. Richard Ebright is a very famous scientist. He has received many awards. And what does he research on? Biochemistry and molecular biology. These are his fields of research. Biochemistry and molecular biology. It was his fascination for butterflies. And how did he become a scientist? It was his love for butterflies that opened the world of science to him. So, at the age of 22, a former scout of the year. So, he was a former scout. Former means before. Before he was the scout of the year. At the age of 22, a former scout of the year excited the scientific world with a new theory on how cells work. So what was his specialty? He gave a new theory on how cells work. Can you hear me, all of you? My voice is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the... At the age of 22, this scientist gave a new theory to the world. And what new theory he gave? How cells work. Richard H. Ebright, this is his full name, Richard H. Ebright, and his college roommate explained the theory in an article in the Proceedings of National Academy of Science. This is the name of the magazine or journal where his article was published. So he was working along with his roommate, college roommate, and he explained his new theory on how cells work in which magazine? In the Proceedings of National Academy of Science. It was the first time this important scientific journal had ever published the work of college students. So usually this scientific magazine does not publish the work of college students. Is scientific journal mein sirf famous scientists ka article publish hota hai. To pehli baar aisa hua ki kisi student ka article jo hai wo is magazine mein publish hua ho. So what was the important thing? That for the first time the article of a student was published in this magazine. In sports, that would be like making the big leagues at the age of 15. So if you compare it to sports, a 15-year-old person making the big league at the age of 15. League means place of winning. So a big league. League here means place of winning in a baseball game. So place of winning in a baseball game. So if you compare it with sports, a 15-year-old young person making a place of winning in a baseball game. So if you compare it with a sports person, it is the same kind of achievement that a 15-year-old person winning in a baseball game at the age of 15 and hitting a home run, your first time at bat. First time the 15-year-old sportsman uses his bat, he wins. It can be compared to a sportsman who wins for the first time. Just a 22-year-old person publishing an important research in the magazine. For Richard Ebright, it was the first in a long string of achievements. Ye Richard Ebright ka pehla achievement tha, lekin ye last nahi tha. It continued. String of achievements means what? His achievements continued. He published an article in a famous magazine at the age of 22. This was not his only achievement. His achievement continued, a string of achievements in science and other fields. And it all started with butterflies. Aur scientist banne ka story jo hai wo shuru kahan se hua? How did he become a scientist? It started with butterflies. An only child, Ebright grew up north of Reading, Pennsylvania. Reading is the name of the place. Reading matlab yahan padhna nahi. It is the name of place. Where did he grow up? He grew up at a place north of Reading in Pennsylvania. An only child. He was the only child of his parents. No brothers and sisters. He did not have any brothers or sisters. He was the only child of his parents, and which was his birthplace. He grew up in the place called Reading, which is in Pennsylvania. There wasn't much I could do there, he said. I certainly couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. So being an only child, he suffered from loneliness because he couldn't play any game. If for playing any game, you need at least one person. So as a child, he suffered from loneliness. Why? Because he was an only child. He suffered from loneliness. He couldn't play any game alone. So I certainly couldn't play football or baseball with a team of one. Means he says I was all alone at home and I could not play any sports. But there was one thing I could do, collect things. So what he started doing, he could not play any game because he was a single child. So what he started doing, he started collecting things. Collecting things became his hobby. He made his hobby collecting things. So he did. And did he ever? Beginning in kindergarten, when did he start this collection of things? ये चीजों को इकट्ठा करने का जो hobby था वो कब शुरू हुआ? Beginning in kindergarten. Kindergarten is the primary classes, LKG, UKG. Those are the kindergarten. So right from his childhood, when he was very small, he started collecting things. Ebright collected butterflies, and what he started collecting, butterflies, with the same determination that has marked all his activities. So right from the beginning, he was a very determined person. Right from the beginning, he had a strong determination, strong mind. He had a strong mind right from his childhood. So he started collecting things. Butterflies, he also collected rocks, fossils, and coins. Apart from butterflies, what are the other things he started collecting in his childhood? Rocks, fossils, and coins. Fossils. Fossils means old remains, prehistoric remains. When the bones of animals or human beings get buried, they become fossils after many years. Fossils and coins. He became an eager astronomer too, sometimes gazing all night. And also he had interest in astronomy. He became an eager astronomer. And what he used to do, he used to look at the stars, looking. Gazing means looking. So, what were the other interests of Richard H. Ebright? Apart from collecting things like butterflies, rocks, fossils, coins, he also had interest in astronomy. And sometimes he used to look at the stars for whole night. Kabhi kabhi puri raat jo hai wo sirf stars ko observe karte the. So, he had interest in astronomy. And then he also had interest in collecting things. He was an only child, and so he felt very lonely. In his childhood, he couldn't play any games. So he started collecting various things. From the first, he had a driving curiosity along with a bright mind, which were his qualities. He was very, very curious child. Har cheez janne ki unko ichha hoti thi. Curious. Curious matlab jigyasa. So right from his childhood, he was very, very curious and he had a bright mind. So what were his good qualities? He was very intelligent and also he was a curious child. He wanted to know everything that he saw. He wanted to know about it. Intelligent mind. He also had a mother who encouraged his interest in learning. And mother also encouraged Ebright's interest in learning. She took him on trips, brought him telescopes. Because he was interested in astronomy, What did mother buy him? All the equipments related with astronomy, to look at the stars, to look and see what is there in the sky clearly. You need a telescope. Telescope is an instrument. You know what is a telescope? What is a telescope? Hello? Hello?
Ma'am, telescope is a device to see very far objects in space.
Telescope is a device by which you can see objects which are very far. So it is a tube-like instrument to make distant objects appear nearer. It is a tube-like instrument which makes distant objects look nearer. Tube-like instrument which makes distant objects look So it is a tube-like instrument which makes distant objects look nearer. Microscope, you already know. You must have seen microscope in the bio lab, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
It makes tiny things appear bigger. Then cameras, mounting materials means what? Equipments that can be put on pedestal, that can be put on platform, on a platform, jisko koi unche cheez pe rakh sake. Platform. So equipments to be put on the platforms, and helped him in many other ways. So as we see, Ebright's mother was very encouraging. She encouraged him in learning. How did she encourage him? She took him on trips, outings. Trip means what? Outings, visit different places. Trips. Visit to different places. So Ebright's mother took him on to visit different places. Then she purchased all the equipments related to astronomy, telescope by which he could see the objects in the sky clearly. Then microscopes, then cameras, mounting materials, helped him in many ways. I was his only companion until he started school. This line is spoken by his mother. What does his mother say? That she was his only companion till he was in school. Jab wo dost tha, jab wo school gaya tab dost banne lage. Jab tak wo ghar mein tha, chota tha, to who was his only friend? Hello?
My mother.
Mother was his only friend. When he went to school, he made friends, but till he was in the house, till he had not joined school, mother was his only companion until he started school. His mother said, after that, I would bring home friends for him. So mother knew that Ebright, being a single child, felt very lonely. So what did mother do? She brought home friends for him. But at night, we just did things together. At night, Ebright and his mother, they did things together. Richie was my whole life after his father died. Richie is the nickname of Richard. Nickname. Mother calls him by the nickname Richie. What does he say? That her whole priority was her son after his father died. Richie was my whole life after his father died. when Richie was in third grade. So Richard's father had died when he was in third grade. So Richard's father had died at a very young age. Richard's father had died when he was studying in the third grade. And then Richard became the whole life for his mother. She and her son spent almost every evening at the dining table. So she spent most of her time with her son at the dining table. In the evening, where did they spend time together? In the evening, they spent time together at the dining table. If he didn't have things to do, I found work for him. Sometimes when he did not have things, mother would suggest, do this work, do this work, do that work. Not physical work, but learning things. So mother encouraged his curiosity. Mother encouraged the curiosity in him. He was already a curious child, but who encouraged this curiosity? His mother. She kept him encouraging. She encouraged him to learn new things. She encouraged him to learn new things. He liked it. He wanted to learn. He himself was a curious child, and he was encouraged by his mother also. He wanted to learn, and learn he did. He learned many things, and learn he did. He learned many things. He earned top grades in school. So what kind of a student he was? He got good grades in school. So as a student, he was a very successful student. He got good grades in school. On everyday things, he was just like every other kid. So he was very intelligent. He was like every other normal child, but he was very good in studies. He was very curious. He had an intelligent mind. He had interest in astronomy. He had interest in collecting things like butterflies, fossils, rocks, coins. By the time he was in the second grade, Albright had collected all 25 species of butterflies. So you can just imagine a child studying in the second class and how many species of butterflies he had collected. He was just studying in the class two, and he had collected 25 different kinds of butterflies found around his hometown. Aaspaas ke jagah mein, jo reading ke aaspaas, reading was the place where he was brought up. So the area surrounding reading, whatever kinds of butterflies were found, he caught them and collected it. These are the names of the butterflies jo usne collect kiya tha. Ye sara naam hai butterflies ka. Gossamer winged butterflies means very thin winged. Gossamer winged butterflies means butterflies which have a very thin wings. White M hair streak, Acadian hair streak, bronze copper, bog copper, purplish copper. Ye sab species hai. Wood nymphs and satyrs, monarchs, whites and sulfurs, brush footed butterflies. So you have niche category, you have so viceroy, buckeye, white admiral, red spotted purple, hackberry. Ye sab species hai. Pearl crescent. Crescent is the shape of the moon, curved structure. So the name is also according to the color. Haan, color ke according se jo hai wo butterfly, jaisa color waisa unka naam hai. That probably would have been the end of my butterfly collecting, he said. But then my mother got me a children's book called The Travels of Monarch X. So he collected 25 species of butterfly, and he would have stopped collecting butterflies. But then his mother gifted him a book. What was the name of the book that mother gifted? The Travels of Monarch X. The name of the book was The Travels of Monarch X. And this book is about butterflies. That book which told me how monarch butterflies. Monarch means king. What is the meaning of monarch? Monarch means king. So, mother gifted Ebright a book. What was the name of the book? The name of the book was? What was the name of the book that mother gifted?
Monarch X.
Travels of Monarch X. That book which told how monarchs butterfly migrate to Central America. So this book, what was written in the book? The book contained the facts related to monarch butterflies, how the monarch butterflies migrate to Central America, open the world of science to the eager young collector. Who is the eager young collector here? It refers to Ebright. Eager young collector here refers to Ebright. So this book opened a world of science to him. This book aroused interest in science. So this book was a turning point in his life because it aroused his interest in science. This book proved that this book, Travels of Monarch X, it proved to be a turning point, important, because it aroused his interest in science. To the eager young collector. At the end of the book, readers were invited to help study butterfly migrations. And at the end of the book, the writer invited the readers to help study butterfly migrations, how the butterflies migrate to various places. They were asked to tag butterflies for research by Dr. Frederick. So they were asked to tag butterflies, to stick some adhesive tags. Stick, tag butterfly means what? To stick something on the wing of the butterfly. To stick the names. For research by Dr. Frederick. Who was doing the research on butterflies? Dr. Frederick A. Urquhart. A strange name. And he belonged to the University of Toronto, Canada. Ebright's mother wrote to Dr. Urquhart, and soon Ebright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of monarchs. So Ebright's mother wrote a letter to this scientist, Dr. Frederick A. Urquhart. And she wrote to this scientist to help her son in this butterfly research. And soon Ebright was attaching light adhesive tags to the wings of monarchs. So he just stuck the names on the wings of the monarchs, adhesive tags to the wings of the monarch. And anyone who found a tagged butterfly, was asked to send the tag to Dr. Urquhart. And The people were asked to send these butterflies, which were tagged to Dr. Urquhart. So the butterfly collecting season around reading last 6 weeks in late summer. So which is the time of the year when butterflies are found in abundance? It is the 6 weeks in late summer. This is the time when butterflies are found in plenty. The butterfly collecting season around reading. Reading, again, as I told you, it is the name of the place. So the butterfly collecting season around reading lasts 6 weeks in late summer. If you are going to chase them one by one, you won't catch very many. So butterflies, as you know, they fly very quickly. It's very difficult to catch a butterfly. As soon as you go with your fingers near them, they will fly away. So if you are chasing and catching butterflies, you won't be able to catch many butterflies. If you just run after the butterfly and try to catch them, you won't be able to catch many butterflies. But Ebright needed many butterflies for his research. So what did he do? As he needed many butterflies for his research, but catching butterflies is very difficult. So the next step for Ebright was to raise a flock of butterflies. He started raising butterflies in his own house. Flock means group. He started breeding the butterflies in his own house. He would catch a female monarch, take her eggs and raise them in his basement. Basement means underground room. And how would he raise butterflies in his house? He would catch a female monarch. So he would catch a female monarch butterfly, because the female monarch only lays down many eggs, and small butterflies will come from those eggs. So he caught a female butterfly, he took her eggs, and where did he keep those eggs? In the underground room, in the basement. Underground room. Through their life cycle, from egg to caterpillar to pupa to adult butterfly. You know the life cycle of the butterfly. The egg hatches and becomes a caterpillar. Caterpillar can only move on the ground, no wings. After the caterpillar turns to pupa, and then the pupa develops wings and becomes adult butterfly. So he started raising butterflies in his own house because it was not possible to catch so many butterflies. Then he would tag the butterflies, then he would stick the tags on them, name the butterflies, and let them go. For several years, his basement was home to thousands of monarchs. So for many years, if you visited his basement, what could you see? The butterflies in the different stages. His basement was home to thousands of monarchs in different stages of development. So there were thousands of monarchs, butterflies, some pupa, some caterpillar, some just eggs. Different stages of development. So, number and kinds of butterflies collected in 6 weeks. So this is different kinds of butterflies that he had collected. Sabse jyada brush footed collect kiya. उसके बाद गोसामर विंग, उसके बाद वाइट्स एंड सल्फर्स, वुड निम्स एंड स्टायर्स, और सबसे कम कलेक्ट किया मोनार्कस. इवेंचुअली आई बिगैन टू लूज इंटरेस्ट इन टैगिंग बटरफ्लाइज. It's tedious, boring and difficult. Tedious means boring and difficult. So we'll continue tomorrow. Tomorrow is Sunday, on Monday, because this chapter is also coming in your half yearly. So I'll finish it in by Tuesday or Wednesday. Then we will start our revision. I'll take quiz one by one of all the chapters and poems, and even of grammar section. Okay. Is it clear? All of you have to be prepared for that. You'll get marks. Okay. Okay. Bye, all of you. Our class ends here.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, all of you. We'll finish this chapter by Monday, Tuesday, and then we'll start the revision work. Poems, chapters, sabse oral test lenge. Yeah, practice.